Hello, I am Chris Menard. Welcome to my channel. I have a great video for you today. If you're considering purchasing a home for the first time, maybe you're buying a second home or even doing a refi, this is a loan amortization schedule. It was put together by Microsoft. You will be able to download this file and there'll be chapters throughout. We're going to go use this schedule to figure out what is going to be our payment for the principal and interest, but it's not going to include the taxes, insurance, possible PMI, and maybe even homeowners association. But I'll quickly, at the end of this video, I will actually throw in some numbers to show you what the total payment would be if you had all six of these items. But let's go ahead and dive in right now and figure out what's the principal and interest and see how the loan amortization schedule works. So I have this pulled up right now. Loan amount, I'm going to put in $410,000. I believe that is the median home price in Metro Atlanta. Interest rate, I know they're still around 7%. 30 years for the period. Number of payments per year would be 12. And then the final field that we have to put in is the start date of the loan. You can do control semicolon on the keyboard, or you can just type in a date. Today happens to be Sunday, June 30th. And it fills in, if you notice, there's payment 1, 2, 3 listed over there in column B. In case you didn't know this, every payment you pay is going to start off with a lot going to interest and a very little going to principal. That's column H and I. But as you pay for the loan, notice the second payment, more went to principal and less went to interest. If we go to the very bottom, there is payment number 360 and the loan is paid off. Notice in column K, the cumulative interest, $571,000, matches cell I7, the $571,000. Back up to the top, they give you this cool feature here. What if you pay an extra payment every time? I'm putting in the number 100. Watch it fill in column F right there. And of course, your interest would come down because that's going right to principal. Most people don't do that, so I'm going to delete it. But if you wanted to put in an extra payment periodically, you could come in here and just type in the number anywhere you want to. So there you go with 7% interest right there. The only issue with this is that over to the right, that loan summary, the scheduled payment, the 2727 in this example, that is the principal and interest, but it doesn't include all the other stuff, your taxes, your insurance, which I have listed over in column I. And the other big issue is with this, everything's correct, but you need to have a 20% down payment or you'll have to pay private mortgage insurance. That is called PMI. That is insurance that protects the lender, not you. And there's usually a fee for that. So let's go and assume on this example that the loan, the house is $410,000 and you're going to pay 10% down. So let's punch in all the numbers now. I'm going to just do the math here manually. I know that 10% is $41,000. So now we're borrowing $369,000 right there. So over here, this is how this would work. Your payment did go down, by the way. So that number right there, that number 2455, that is your principal and interest. Your taxes, you can get your taxes from whatever county you're looking at for that house. Go to the county website. You should be able to punch in that address and get it. The only item to be careful with is make sure that the taxes that you see aren't someone that could possibly be getting a lot of exemptions. Maybe they're over a certain age. Maybe they have a disability. So just check a few of the houses around there. But I'm going to use the taxes. I'm going to use property taxes of $4,000 for 12 months. Insurance, let's do $1,500 for 12 months. Let's say you don't have any homeowners association fees. That actually, depending on where you live. But here you go. What is going to be, if you pay less than 20% down payment, you're going to have to pay that private mortgage insurance. I took this from bankrate.com, and I'm punching it in here right now. How much does PMI cost? Notice they've got a $410,000 home, and I'm doing the 10% down right here. So let's do the same interest rate that they used. I believe they used 7.96. So let's make this 7.96 just for a second. Notice our payment is $26,97.31. That is exactly what they have here under the 10% column for your monthly payment. And they're showing that you would pay $240 in PMI. So now that we have all these numbers, I can add them all up. And that would be your monthly payment for a $410,000 home with 10% down right there, including your private mortgage insurance. I'll also put some links down below about PMI. You can get rid of it. You'll see that in your PMI disclosure statement. You'll see two percentages. One will be 80%, one will be 78%. But I'll put some information and some links about when that goes away down below. Now, as a bonus, there's a rule called the 28%, 36% rule that lenders use. So if you're wondering, what would be your gross income? What does it need to be to afford this house right here? 28% of your gross is the most that should go to your housing. So if I take that number and divide by 0.28, $12,000, that is your monthly gross, times 12, that is the amount of money you would need to make annually to afford this home with the 28% rule. I'm not going into the 36% portion of it right now. I'm just trying to keep this simple. But I'll definitely put this loan amortization schedule. It is a great feature from Microsoft. I'll put this so you can download this. And I'll even include this links to Bankrate about this PMI right here. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. My Excel classes are available online, including Teams, OneNote, Copilot. Thank you.